When we think of dogs, we often think of strong athletic creatures. We've recognized that, like children, dogs need space to run. So traditionally, pet dogs would run free around the property. However, due to urbanization, we came up with alternative playgrounds for our active canines, like the dog park pictured here. When we think of wild birds, we often think of watching them fly across the sky. But traditionally, the pet bird has been given a more limited space to roam and play, typically a perch in a cage. Why the double standard? Maybe that's because people were most familiar with canaries and finches, which do well enough in limited spaces, or maybe it's because birds are so small compared to other domestic pets. But for some reason, we tend to categorize parrots more with cats for activity level. We don't think of pet parrots as needing a lot of space or exercise. Parrots may be small, but they are extreme athletes. Many species of parrots will fly miles a day. Approximately 20% of a bird's weight is attributed to the largest muscle in their body, the pectoral chest muscle. Rapid beating of flight wings takes immense energy and specialized muscles that love to move. A less active parrot needs exercise to burn off that extra energy they store in their system, just like a child needs to be able to run around. A flighted pet parrot can blow off that extra energy with flight, but those that are not flighted need to somehow get more aerobic exercise. Based on the way a skilled flighted bird hurls himself into flight just for the fun of it, I am hypothesizing that there may be a special euphoria birds get from working their muscles. I equate it to the runner's high that a human athlete gets when they work out. To help visualize a bird's amazing muscles, let's consider the flapping speed of a normal parrot. When photographers take a picture of a professional runner or ball player, they get stop action at a 500th of a second. However, to stop most large parrots in flight takes a 1,000th of a second. That is, the shutter speed needs to be twice as fast. And some of the fastest wing beaters will blur even then, as you can see in this photo, which was taken at a 1,000th of a second. Look at the tips of the wings. You can see the blurring there. How much energy do birds use to take off and fly hard? Well, even if humans could grow wings, we wouldn't have enough energy to fly the way birds do. A bat is the only mammal that flies by flapping, and their system isn't up to the level of a bird. Did you know that most bats don't even have enough strength or energy to lift their bodies off from the ground? I will quote from Habitat for Bats. "Most bats cannot take flight from the ground. They must drop 2 or 3 feet before they can fly. In the wild, birds expend a ton of energy just finding food and staying alive, yet pet parrots don't have to worry about running from predators or looking for a meal. How important is it, then, that our pet parrots are active? A bunch of research on humans have clearly linked inactivity in humans to metabolic and mortality issues. There is now a whole field called inactivity research dedicated to studying and trying to cure diseases associated with it. A study by David Dunstan, published in the journal Circulation, looked at nearly 9,000 Australians and found that for each additional hour of television a person sat and watched per day, the risk of dying rose by 11%. It would make sense that animals wouldn't be a lot different. In fact, we now know how badly it can affect some animals. Mark Hamilton, an inactivity researcher at the Pennington Biomedical Research Center, has documented some of the depressing facts from his work with rats. In studies of rats who were forced to be inactive, he discovered that the leg muscles responsible for standing almost immediately lost more than 75% of their ability to remove harmful lipoproteins from the blood. Of course, inactivity will probably affect the avian species somewhat differently, but given that obesity in pet parrots is already being referred to by vets as an epidemic, this surely reinforces that we should be concerned. Humans have learned it's not easy to keep a low weight by dieting alone, and even the best of diets doesn't offer the aerobic benefits of exercise. There's also a lot of circumstantial evidence that lack of exercise is contributing to pet bird behavioral issues. Here's yet another reason to get perch potato birds off their perches. As parrots get older, the bottom of their feet can develop a degenerative condition called bumblefoot or pododermatitis. It's caused when the foot is always making contact with the perch in the same spot. It can be avoided by not sitting in one place as much and having a variety of perches with different diameters and shapes. Also, limiting the amount of time on rough or very hard perches is recommended. So what options do we have for exercising and perching?